here at the Stanbic Training Center with Professor Patricia Green.
Hi.
So we're going to get a one-on-one with her and get to know her a little bit. So how are you enjoying Zambia so far?
I'm really enjoying Zambia.
How's the weather? Is it hotter than what you're usually used to?
This is a nice warm winter, but I live in Texas.
Yeah.
So it's really fairly similar than a lot of Texas.
So how's the training program going so far?
We're having a lot of fun with it.
Okay.
I think we're really diving into it. The whole idea is that it's about practicing on their own businesses. So there's no lectures, there's not a lot of PowerPoints. It's really, how do you work on your own business in order to grow?
Okay. I was looking at one of the media releases by Langmead and Baker, mm-hmm. and there was something you're doing with the class where you laid out Chitenga pieces.
Mm-hmm.
What was going on there?
I don't want to tell you the secret of it, though, for all the other women that may eventually take the class. Let's just say that we were working on changing mindset about how to be entrepreneurial and how to look at the world as opportunity obsessed.
Okay.
So that's kind of the teaser.
Speaking of mindsets, what kind of mindset do you think somebody needs to have to make it as an entrepreneur?
We really define being entrepreneurial in a couple of different ways. There, it starts with that opportunity obsession, just looking around the world and seeing lots of opportunity. Then it goes into being able to access and organize resources, the people you need, the money you need, the space you need, whatever, the technology you need. Then it gets to leadership, actually being able to develop your own vision and have it that people want to follow you so that you can create value. And that's our wrap up. So the whole mindset is one of tasks and skills to create value.
So speaking of opportunities, personally, how have you taken that up? Can we say, well, not right now, because we know that you really have a great reputation in terms of entrepreneurship.
Well, thank you.
Yes. So looking at, let's say, past you, young you, as you were starting out in this world of entrepreneurship, how did you look at opportunities and how did you take that on?
That's a really good question. I don't know that anyone's ever asked me quite that before.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, that's very cool. I think I learned early to really look for opportunities. My dad, while I was in school, took a correspondence course because there was no internet.
Okay.
So he took a correspondence course. He worked in a foundry. He was a molder. I mean, very hot, dirty job all day long. And he took this course and became an appliance repairman. And then he bought this old gas station. And inside the gas station, he sold appliances. He fixed appliances, he sold gas. It was just kind of anywhere he looked that he saw something people needed, he stepped in. So I think from very early on, I saw that as a pathway. And I like different things. I like when something unexpected comes up. So I think because I look for the unexpected, that usually leads to opportunities.
So how would you say the internet has really helped out in terms of entrepreneurs? How is it an advantage to them, and how can they use it to build on their businesses?
I think there's three ways you can really use the internet well. One is just general knowledge. You know, you can learn so much about anything on there. The second is connecting. You can reach out to people all around the world and ask questions and share answers and brainstorm, those types of things. And the third is operations. You can look like a much larger business if you're using technology and do things a lot more efficiently. So if you put all that together, it's an amazing tool.
Okay, I'll actually use that myself.
Go for it.
Taking notes.
Have at it.
So I did a little stalking and I got to look at interviews that you've done. And there's one interview that I was looking at which really caught my attention. So you were asked if you had a plan B.
Okay.
And then your answer was, you actually thought of bartending.
Oh, that interview.
Yes, that interview.
Uh-huh.
So that's thinking, bartending, why would you think of bartending?
Well, I worked when I went through school as a waitress, and once in a while they let me tend bar. And I just think you learn so much about people, you know, just having conversations, hearing conversations. And I think, I do believe that to be a great entrepreneur, you have to really understand people. What do they need? How do they think? You know, what causes them pain? What causes them pleasure? All those kinds of things.
Okay. So as you were waitressing, what would you say was the best or the most memorable moment or day that you had?
Oh my goodness, it's been quite a while.
Yeah.
My most memorable day. I think it was Oh no, I know what it was. Okay. Now that I think about it, one of my early waitressing jobs was at it was a tourist place. My family was Pennsylvania Dutch, so we lived in Pennsylvania. They at that time lived in Pennsylvania, and a lot of tour buses would come to see the Pennsylvania Dutch because, you know, some, not all of us, but some are the ones with the horses and the buggies and that kind of thing still today. And I was serving, and it was the great big buses and family styles and carrying trays, and it was grueling, grueling work. And I remember going home that night, sitting down, and my mom actually brought me a bucket to soak my feet, and I thought, I really need to find a better place, you know, a better way to do this. So that was one of those opportunities that helped me learn what I didn't want to do all the time.
Yeah. Okay. So when it comes to bucket lists, mm-hmm. do you have a bucket list?
I do have a bucket list.
So would you share with us like the three things on your bucket list?
Okay.
I want to go to Antarctica while it's still there.
Yes.
So I think, you know, that's a really important one. I think all my bucket lists, two of my bucket lists are traveling. So I've never done a transatlantic ocean voyage. I'd like to do that. But I'd also like to write a book. All my books that I've written, except for one, were for people on how to teach entrepreneurship. I'd really like to take everything that I learned over basically teaching entrepreneurship on every continent except Antarctica and write it into a book that everybody could use, just a day-to-day trade kind of book that would be really helpful in teaching people how to be entrepreneurial.
That's definitely on my to-read list, so I am looking forward to that.
Well, that's going to force me to get my bucket list done.
Yes. So then, we're talking beauty now.
Okay.
And as ladies, we're quite obsessed with how we look.
In teaching people how to be entrepreneurial.
That's definitely on my to-read list, so I am looking forward to that.
Well, that's going
to
force me to get my bucket list done.
Yes. So then, we're talking beauty now.
Okay.
And as ladies, we're quite obsessed with how we look. We need to look a certain way. What are the three things that you cannot leave your house without?
Well, before you even say, I am definitely buying better shoes before I come here next time.
Yes.
Because you all have amazing shoes. So, the three things I can't leave at home without, moisturizer.
Yes.
I pull my big ones. I do wear comfortable shoes just because I'm up in front of the classroom for many, many, many hours. And I love beautiful shawls, you know, beautiful materials and textiles and that type of thing. So I always have one of those with me.
So I noticed that Babson College actually has a blog.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
So how has the blog, how has the blog helped the college?
I think it's made it more personable, more human. People get to learn other parts of us, you know, so sometimes I will blog when I'm traveling or something like that, or someone just notices something unusual. So it's not just the usual PR kinds of things, which are very important, but it makes it a little more personal.
Okay. Well, in terms of blogging in Zambia, it's something that is quite new and that is growing. So how would you advise companies in the corporate world, it could even be universities, how can they take advantage of using a blog or having a blog personally?
Mm-hmm. Know what your message is. You know, why are you blogging? I think a lot of people do social media just because they think they should do social media.
Yeah.
So really understanding why you're doing it, then understanding your values for your blog, you know, the kind of language you will use, won't use, those kind of things. And then lastly, make it interesting. Teach something in it. I think people have so many opportunities to read, to listen to. There's so much information out there. How are you going to cut through the chatter?
Definitely, I hope everybody heard that.
Cut through the chatter. Yes.
Cut through it. So in terms of, I know that you focus mostly on women in entrepreneurship.
Mm-hmm.
What would your comment be on women empowering?
Mm-hmm.
What would you have to say about that?
I really like that question because I think it's important that we do support each other,
yeah.
Whether it's as customers, as employees, as suppliers, just paying attention. And